share this as an eye. That's one of them. It looks like a patch again, wearing a veil over the wizard's eye. The wizard's right here. And the wizard is that little fucking thing on the moon, the pimples on the moon. I'll explore into some of this imagery as well. So, oh yeah, here we go. So the wizard is there. Focus in better. again, please keep an eye out on the Sea of Tranquility. All in here, look for the imagery in here. All this should be pretty clear within a few seconds. You should start picking up all of these. But up here in the Sea of Tranquility, look at them. Notice that all of these stay the same all the time. They never change. No atmosphere is going to move any of this imagery. Every time this thing comes rolling through our fucking sky in the veil and we see it, it's always the same imagery. So if I'm at this distance, at this angle, I'm going to see this exact imagery over and over and over again. And if I grab it at a different angle with different light coming, not, I shouldn't say into it anymore, but different light coming into my telescope, then it'll shine and blur things out here and there for me. I allow that to happen on purpose. I let the shine, I deal with it now. It used to aggravate me, but now I deal with it. Because what it'll do is it'll pick up other imagery that I would not normally have seen from that particular angle. So I just roll with it. Get my pen out of there.
Thank you.
rest of the image is there, just like in the clouds. Just like if they don't chemtrail us and you only have a few clouds sputtering around, parts of it will be missing. But you'll see the eyes, the eyebrows, and maybe a mouth down here, and that's all you'll get out of it until they chemtrail us. And they dump the heavy metals all over the place, and then all of a sudden, there'll be full imagery. Same thing. So, in light, also, you know, light hitting it at certain angles is going to give it to you. Well, at least more realistic. Kind of like, again, like the clouds. The clouds look too puffy and cartoony for people to take them seriously until you show them the clear ones, like with a lot of detail on them. So, when you have to get them, when you're taking photographs or video of them, you have to get them at the right angle of light. And it looks so fucking beautiful. You're like, wow, what great artists, man. These guys do some great work. Meaning the nanocarbon. They take their orders seriously, and they design this imagery all around us. The trees, the ice, everything. The ground, the rocks, the stone, the atmosphere, the moon, the veil, everything. Is these nanocarbon design, us included. A lot of questions still, a lot of questions, but this is, it's gotten really far in the last 4 to 6 months. Meaning that I found it all the way down to the microscopic scale. That's fucking unbelievable. I mean, it was just one thing after another, and then years and years of research and looking around all just come together. It's wonderful. The questions would be, why only 6 species? Why only the 6 species? Or 6 images, I should say. I don't even want to call them species anymore. Why only the 6 images? When we know that the Earth has more than that, right? It's very strange that the nanocarbon just choose these 6 images to keep repeating over and over.